Now we are going to discuss about workflow. So in earlier classes we discussed about the run task command. So the run task command will help us to call another subtask inside a main task. But workflow is a different kind of thing. We can run the task based on the decision. So let me open this workflow here. Workflow will be there. So here I am taking new. Not this one. Here I need to take new workflow here. So whenever I take the new workflow, it's a kind of UML diagram. So first I need to drag the start. So I am starting this, then run task. So here I need to select a task. I am going with the RPA matrix. I'll go with the XML operations one. XML get single node one. So I am running this. So now here two scenarios. If successful, if unsuccessful. If task successful, you need not to do anything. In my situation, I am going to stop this one. If task unsuccessful, again I am running another task. I want to go with the RPA matrix, another one. Update XML node. I'll go with this one. Save. Again, if you want to write any conditions like this, you can write. So all this depends in the if condition. This is one. So whenever this particular task successful, again, if a particular file exists, let me check. Okay, let me do. I'm taking some random one. I'm saving this. See, again, true false. So here we need to build the false conditions, true conditions according to our requirements. So basically this workflow will help us to build the workflow. For suppose if this success task is success, I need not to do anything. If this task is fail, I need to run some other task. So this is going to help us to take the proper decisions. So if I run this one, so let me save custom workflow. So at the end of the day, we need to close all the points with the end command. See, sub, it's get the value done. So if this is not able to run in successful way, it will go here and it will check all these things. It purely depends on the requirement. Basically this is about workflow. And one more thing, the variable manager, if you observe here, workflow can support only one type of variable. That is value type. The two, we have to define the value here itself. We are not able to read this value from any other external text files kind of thing. This is the limitation of the workflow. So this is about workflow, guys.